Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Meenal Dhal from Department of Anthropology, University of Delhi. Today, we'll study the module Biostatistics and Epidemiologic Method from the paper Research Methods and Fieldwork. Now, let's start with the learning objectives of this module. So, after completing this module, you will know about the basic knowledge of biostatistics and epidemiological methods. Then we'll also discuss about the biostatistical analysis and its application. Then the third objective of this study will be to elucidate the types of epidemiological methods. And the next one is to understand the distribution, disease, occurrence and determinants of the disease. Now, first of all, we'll briefly discuss about the biostatistics. In modern research, biostatistics is used extensively in epidemiology. For example, biostatistics was used in research for the development of polio vaccine in the 1950s. The science of epidemiology began by investigating the infectious disease outbreaks. However, it is also concerned with other complex diseases such as heart disease, cancer, stroke, diabetes, hypertension, and many others. Biostatistics is used to determine how disease develop, progress, and spread. It also predicts the behavior of the disease, like the symptoms, individual who are at risk, the mortality and morbidity rate of the population, and so on. Epidemiology is the basic science of public health. It uses the statistical tools and research methodologies to find out the causes and risk of certain diseases in certain population groups. Now, the combination of biostatistics and epidemiological research significantly enhance the methodology, study design, disease etiology, controlling as well as in preventing the outbreak of the disease. Now let's talk about the data. Data is one of the most important and vital aspect of any research study. It is a collection of items of information. In other words, it is the information in raw or unorganized form that refer to or represents the conditions, ideas or objects. It is common to all fields of study, including physical and social sciences, medical and clinical studies, humanities, businesses, and so on. Everywhere, data is the first priority to collect. Accurate and complete data are essential to maintain the integrity of research and to understand the research problem. A complete collection of data on the group under study is called population. And the collection of sampling units selected from the population is known as sample. Now, the sampling unit is the smallest unit of data which is represented by a member of the population. Now, in research, a small representative sample is used to study population, as it is very difficult to collect information from each and everyone in the population. Moreover, studying a whole population is expensive and time consuming. Now, data can be classified into two types. The first is qualitative and second is quantitative type of data. Now, qualitative type of data are those where the observation or information characterized by measurement on the categorical scale. It is the information about the qualities and information that cannot actually be measured. It describes quality of the studied subject. For example, softness of skin, ethnic mortality, gender, nationality, etc. Qualitative data are generally described in terms of percentages or proportions. It is mostly displayed by showing the contingency table, pie chart and bar charts. The other type of data is quantitative data. It is the data which give information about the numerical quantities that can be measured and written down with numbers. They are the observations for which the differences between numbers have meaning on a numerical scale. It measures the quantity of something. The quantitative data can be classified into two subgroups of on the basis of type of numerical scale. The first one is continuous scale, like height of an individual, and the second is discrete scale, like number of pregnancies. Now, quantitative data are described in terms of mean and standard deviation. It is mostly displayed in the frequency tables and histograms. Now, another type is variables. What is variable? It is a characteristic that can take on different values for different members of the group under study. For example, a group of university students will be found to differ in gender, height, attributes, intelligence, and many ways. These characteristics are called variables because the value may vary between data units in a population and it may change in the value over time. It is any characteristic, number, or quantity that can be measured or counted. Variables are categorized into different types based on their scale, like numerical variable. These have values that describe a measurable quantity as a number, like how many or how much. Therefore, numeric variables are quantitative variables. It is further divided into continuous and discrete variables. Now, in continuous variables, it is the variable that can take on any value between its minimum value and its maximum value. The examples of continuous variables include height, time, age, temperature, blood pressure, etc. On the other hand, the discrete variable or the discrete values are only designated values of the integer values like 1, 2, 3. For example, the discrete variables include number of children in a family, number of car in a house, etc. All of which measured as a whole unit. Now, another variable is dependent variable. A dependent variable is the variable being tested and measured in a scientific experiment. It is a variable that is dependent on an independent variable. For example, time spent in study and test score. Here, the time spent is the independent variable and the test score is the dependent variable because time spent in study causes a change in the test score. The third type of variable is independent variable. An independent variable is a variable that is changed or controlled in an experiment to test the effect of the dependent variable. In other words, it is the variable that is being manipulated in accordance with the purpose of the researcher to observe the effect of a dependent variable. It is also known as the outcome variable. A change in the independent variable directly causes a change in the dependent variable. Now, the fourth category is the categorical variable. These have values that describe a quality or characteristic of a data unit, like what type or which category. It falls into mutually exclusive and exhaustive categories. Hence, these variables are qualitative variables and represented by a non-numeric value. It may be further divided into ordinal and nominal variable. The ordinal variable is a categorical variable. Observation can take a value that can be logically ordered or ranked. The categories can be ranked higher or lower than another, but no consistent level of magnitude between the groups. For example, academic grade A, B, C, attitudes like strongly agree, disagree, strongly disagree. On the other hand, the nominal variables have those observations that can take a value that is not able to be organized in a logical sequence. For example, gender, business type, eye color, religion, etc. Now we'll start with the methods of analysis topic. Now, what are the methods of analysis? The first is inferential statistical method. The inferential statistical method provides a confirmatory data analysis. It generalizes the conclusion about the population from the sample data. It is used to make an inference on the basis of data about the non-existence of a relationship between the independent and the dependent variables. It also assesses the strength of the evidence and makes the future predictions, like how much risk a person has in future. Then another one is descriptive statistics. Descriptive statistics describes the frequency and distribution to characterize the data collection from a group of sample to represent the population. For example, the percentage of patients attending in a diabetes clinic, or gender, or age group, or educational level of the patients, and so on. It describes the important characteristics of a known set of population data. Some of the important descriptive statistical analyses include frequency distribution, central tendency, dispersion, and association. What is frequency distribution? It is one of the most important means of summarizing the data from a single variable. It can be computed by tabulating the frequency on a variable, the quantitative variables with many possible values. The values are typically grouped into intervals. The relative frequency as proportion is calculated as when the value relative frequency is multiplied with 100%. It gives the relative frequency as percent. Now, measurement of central tendency. Central tendency include mean, median, and mode. Now, first we'll discuss mean. The sample mean measures the location or central tendency of the observation in the sample. Its value dependent equally on all the data in ordinal or nominal variables. Mean is not an appropriate measure for estimating the population mean. Another method is median. It is defined as the point on a scale such that above or below it lies 50% of the cases. In other words, it is the value half or 50th percentile of the ordered data set. The median is appropriate for ordinal qualitative data as well as quantitative data. The median is the mean of the middle two numbers when the number of observation, that is n, is even. The third one is mode. What is mode? It is the most common and frequently occurring value in a set of a discrete data. It is used for all the data types. Mode can be more than one if two or more values are equally common in the data set. Now, we'll discuss about the measurement of dispersion. The measurement of dispersion is used to describe the variability in a given sample. In other words, it is the study of spread and dispersion of data. The dispersion measurement include range, percentile, variance, standard deviation, standard error, and interquartile range. Now, one by one, we'll explain all these methods or types. The first one is range. It is the difference between the smallest and the largest value in a set of observation. It uses only the two extreme values, such as the lowest and the highest, and other values in the data set are ignored. Second is interquartile range, called as IQR. Now, interquartile range is the distance between first and third quartile. In other words, it is the difference between the upper quartile and the lower quartile of the whole data set. It is used in statistical analysis to draw conclusion about a set of numbers. The IQR is not sensitive to extreme values. It helps in understanding the spread or dispersion of a set of numbers. Thus, it is usually described together with the median is in skewed distribution of observation. Another one is percentile. Now, percentile indicates the percentage of the individual who have equal to below a given value. Now, the next one is variance. The variance is defined as the average of the squared differences from the mean. The sum of squared distances of each term in the distribution from the mean divided by the number of terms in the distribution. It measures the spread or dispersion within a set of sample data. It provides the information about how individual differs within the sample. Another important component is standard deviation, called as SD. It is the measure of spread or dispersion of a set of data. It gives the information about the variability of scores around the mean. The standard deviation is calculated to reflect the range of samples, and it is appropriate for normal or nearly normal data. It is also calculated by taking the square root of the variance. Larger the value of standard deviation, the data are more widely spread. Now, another component is standard error. It is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of a statistics. It is a relationship between the dispersion of the sample mean and the actual mean of the population. It is estimated from the standard deviation. It indicates about the certainty of the mean and the standard error of the mean. Refers to the standard deviation of the distribution of sample mean taken from the population. The standard error is inversely proportional to the sample size. That is, larger the sample size, the smaller is the standard error, because the dispersion of the sample means clusters more closely around the population mean. Now, we'll discuss about the relationship analysis through chi-square. What is chi-square? It is a test which is calculated to the independence of two categorical variables. It gives the association or relationship between the two categorical variables when chi-square is found to be significant. The data are summarized in two-way contingency table, which represents the observation count table. Another component is correlation coefficient. Correlation coefficient, abbreviated as small r, it provides a measure of the strength of the relationship between two quantitative variables. It is computed from the formula which is showing in your screen. Another part is relative risk. Relative risk for the disease and exposure is defined as the ratio of the hazard of disease among exposed subjects and that among unexposed subjects. Another one is odds ratio. It is a measure of association between an exposure and an outcome. The odds ratio value represents the odds that an outcome will occur given a particular exposure compared to the odds of the outcome occurring in the absence of that exposure. It compares the odds of disease of those exposed to the odds of disease those who are unexposed. And the formula for computing the odds ratio is showing in the screen. Another important parameter is regression. Regression analysis is a statistical analysis for estimating the relationship among variables. It is used to find what relationship, if exists, between the sets of data. It is used to find equations that fit the data. Linear regression is a way to model the relationship between two variables. However, in case of single regression model with more than one outcome variable, multivariate regression analysis are performed. Now the figure illustrates the health determinants. The triad consists of interactions of an external agent, a host, and an environment maintaining the balance, keeping the system in equilibrium state. The agent is the cause of disease and what of the triangle. Host are organism, usually human or animal, which are exposed to the harbor a disease. It is second part of the epidemiological triad and known as WHO. On the other hand, the environment is the favorable surrounding and conditions external to the host that causes or allow disease transmission. It is the remaining part of the triangle of epidemiological triad and known as WHERE. The disease prevails when the system is in disequilibrium, disturbed by change in any of the factors. Now the role of epidemiologists come. The epidemiologist assess the disturbed system and aims to break at least one of the sides of the disturbed triangle, disrupting the connection to stop the continuation of the disease. Now the figure illustrates the different epidemiological methods. Epidemiological method is basically concerned with the distribution of health events in a population. Now various epidemiological methods of studies can be used to carry out the epidemiological investigations. In general, the epidemiologic method focuses on two main aspects, such as descriptive and analytical approach to understand the determinants of health events as well as to develop the effective strategies to prevent them. The descriptive epidemiology describes the occurrence of disease characterizing the health events by time, space, and person. It pertains to who, what, and where, and when the health events occurred. Therefore, the descriptive studies can be used to study the distribution of the frequency and pattern of the health events. On the other hand, the analytic epidemiology used to study the determinants of the health events, such as how and what are the responsible factors for the health events. The analytic epidemiology can be further classified into two groups, that is observational epidemiology and experimental epidemiology. The observational epidemiology observes as well as estimates the association between the exposure and the disease through different methods of studies, including cohort, case control, cross-sectional and ecological type of studies. While on the other hand, the experimental epidemiology focuses on intervention and treatment of the health event through randomized controlled trial, field trial, and community trial. However, the epidemiology also applies other methodological techniques of allied disciplines, including biostatistics and informatics, with biological, economical, social, and behavioral sciences. Now we'll discuss about the disease occurrence. The occurrence of disease in a population in epidemiological studies can be classified into different levels on the basis of extent of prevalence. The different levels of disease occurrence are sporadic level, which include disease that occur occasionally or infrequently at irregular intervals. Second is epidemic level, the persistent occurrence of a disease with a low to moderate level. Then third one is hyperendemic level, persistently high level of disease occurrence. Next one is epidemic, that is suddenly increase in the disease occurrence above normal expected level of a given time period. Fifth one is outbreak, refers to the same meaning with the epidemic, but it is often used for a more limited geographical area. Sixth is pandemic. Epidemic spread over several countries or continents, usually affecting a large number of people. Now, what are the measures of disease? As we discussed before, frequency. In epidemiological studies, there are several means by which the occurrence of disease may be measured. Some of the important measures of disease frequency and risk are shown in a table. Then the count in the number of individuals who meet the disease criteria. The prevalence is the ratio of number of new and old cases at a point of time to the population. The ratio is the ratio of individuals who meet disease criteria to the individual who do not meet the disease criteria. Another one is cumulative incidence, or the incidence proportion is the ratio of number of new cases over a time period to the population at risk at the outset. Incidence density, or incidence rate, is the ratio of number of new cases over a time period to the individual time at risk, and risk is the probability of an individual meeting the disease criteria. Now let us summarize whatever we have discussed till now. The biostatistics is a broad discipline encompassing the application of statistical theory. The biostatistical research is closely connected with the real applications, such as designing and conducting the biomedical experiments and clinical trials. The biostatisticians applied different statistical tools and mathematics to enhance the biological science and to bridge the gap between theory and practice. The epidemiology is the systematic and scientific study of the frequency distribution and determinants of health-related states and events in specified population. Epidemiology has helped in developing the study design and methods used in clinical research, public health studies. It is not just the study of health in the population, but also involves diagnosis of the health problem and to propose the appropriate, practical, and acceptable public health interventions to control and prevent the disease in a community. Thank you.